I've had so many people say, man, we were in Ferguson, Missouri, went into heat of that last time after we left left here in August, went straight there a couple of weeks later, and you know, that was been set up for a year. There was no fighting going on. There was none of that stuff going on when we set up that meeting. We go into it, and here's this portal that the Lord reveals to me there. So why he said it, he said, Satan has opened a portal for murder to be spread to your entire nation here in Ferguson. And here's what he said to me. He said, I want you to open, make an opening with the angels. Release the angels. That's what he said to me. That a command of the supreme commander Christ came directly to me. Release the angelic forces. So I released them. They made mincemeat out of the demons. Pushed them back, created an opening. Just what the Lord told me would happen, happened. He said, here's what you want. You want the ladder to come down right onto this spot. Open another portal in order to try to close that portal. That's the fight we're in. Here's what they're not telling you in the media. They're not telling you about the warlock who got saved in the streets. They're not telling you about the people of God who get in between the protesters and the police and are worshiping God and praising God until the protesters leave. They don't get into, the media doesn't tell you about the police department who's given their thanks to the intercessors who are there and out in the streets fighting. They're not telling you that. But that's the truth of it. Angelic armies began to be released into the area to counter the demonic armies that had gathered for the purpose of the enemy to spread racial war to our entire nation. Are we okay with that? I'm not okay with that. How about you? St. Louis is not meant to be a gateway of evil to the nation. That's what we said. We declared that. St. Louis will not be a gateway of evil to our nation. Arise, people of God, and take your city. How about that? How about that fight? It gets our blood stirred again. It gets the warring spirit within us, the fervency of spirit. It's not over. I'm sorry, I'm not going to say the rest of it. It's not over. We're not defeated. We're not fighting to win a victory. We're fighting for a victory that's already been won to be enforced down upon their heads. That's the fight we're in. We would bring the victory of Christ right down onto those evil powers' heads. God has left them here in the land for us to deal with them. To learn to fight. I love God for that, don't you? Listen, nothing's worse than being a warrior and nobody to fight. It's true. I think of one thing worse is having all these bullets and not enough targets. I ain't like that, Ed. Oh, that's funny. Oh, well. Okay, so you feel that warring thing within you? We're going to fight. I'm serious in this. This isn't a game. I'm not just trying to do a pep rally here. I'm trying to get us alert, sober-minded, engaged in the fight, beginning right with our own marriages, right in our own homes, right with our own children, right with our own grandchildren, right with our immediate family, and then the family of God.